Are you feeling lost? Do you feel like there is more to life? Do you feel like you have a higher purpose? If you said yes to any of those, then this is the book review for you. Peace, love, and namaste, guys. What is up? It is your boy, Isai, aka The Alchemist, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, definitely like, subscribe, and do all that stuff that you know what to do. So today, we're talking about my favorite book and the book that changed my life, The Alchemist, by Paulo Coelho. Now, some of you guys may have heard this book, and some of you guys may have not. Let me give you a quick summary of what the book's about. So without ruining anything, the basic plot of The Alchemist is a young shepherd named Santiago, and he goes on this journey and meets different mentors throughout his journey. He meets a gypsy, he meets a king, and he meets an alchemist. And basically why he's on this journey is because he keeps having recurring dreams of this little kid, and this kid is telling him that there's this treasure in Egypt. And at the time, he didn't know what Egypt was or where it was or anything like that. And he didn't find out until he met the gypsy of what exactly Egypt was. So the basic plot for the book is this young shepherd going on this journey across the country, across the world actually, to find out what his treasure is. And along the way, he finds different people, new friends, a love, and goes through, you know, just the basic things of life, like good things and bad things. Now, let me give you context of why I read this book. So when I first read this book, I was at a point in my life where, honestly, I was very lost. I just have dropped out of college. I was going to college for a couple years, and I realized it wasn't for me, and it wasn't the path that I wanted to do. You know, it was forced upon me by society and my family, because that was the only thing that they taught me was the route to be successful. You gotta go to college to be successful. You gotta get an education to be successful and everything like that. And I ended up dropping out, and I just felt so lost. I didn't know what to do with my life. I had a basic philosophy of what I was good at and what I wanted to do, which was video creation and storytelling and everything like that, but I was still very lost. And when I found this book, and actually my dad recommended it to me, because he told me it changed his life and it changed his perspective when he was at the point where I was feeling right there, and it absolutely changed my life. From the day I read that, I had found my purpose, and I've always known my purpose, but it finally came into light. It finally showed, like, dang, this is my purpose. This is why I need to do this. This is why I need to do that. So I was at a very, you know, unstable, lost point in my life before I read this book. Now, for anyone who's interested in this book, or I guess I should say who should read this book, is exactly what I said. If you feel like you're at a point in your life where you're very lost right now, whether it's in a relationship, whether it's in your personal life, whether it's just in general, of you not knowing where to go or what to do in your life, this is the book for you. And I can say from personal experience and just from other people's reviews of this book, this is gonna change your life. This is gonna change your perspective on where you should go and what you should do with your life. Because, like I said about Santiago, it's literally a story about this young man going through this journey of life, trying to figure out what his personal legend was, what his purpose is in life, what that treasure was. And I'm not gonna ruin it, because you need to read it, because it's a very good story. But he did end up finding his treasure, and it was somewhere that he never expected. For anyone that feels lost in life right now, this is the first book I read. Out of all the book reviews that you're gonna see, this is the book that you need to read, because it's gonna build the foundation of which you lay on, that's gonna take you onto the next path, wherever you need to go. Now, a couple key takeaways from this book I'm gonna go through, so you can kind of get a general gist of what you're gonna get out of this book. The first one is learning to recognize omens. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, well, Isai, what's an omen? And when I first read this book, I didn't know what an omen was either. I actually had to look it up. And basically, think of an omen as a sign. You know, whether you're religious or spiritual or atheist, whatever the case may be, it doesn't really matter in this context right here. But an omen is a sign from the universe, a sign from God, a sign from just being a sign. And you might have had points in your life where a person has left, a person has came in, even some things where you're walking and someone drives by and you see something in their car window, or you're walking by and you look up to a building and the sign says, go this way, you know? And it might, you might be thinking to yourself, well, I have had those things, or, oh, well, I actually haven't. But I can definitely tell you, you have. You just might not have known they were omens. There were signs. So the key lesson that you're going to take away from this book is you're going to learn how to recognize omens, and you're going to learn how to recognize signs from whatever you believe in, saying this is the right way or this isn't the right way. The second key takeaway is life is interesting when you have a dream. Now, I think I'm going to have two people that I watch this. One person being, they know exactly what their dream is, they know what they're passionate about, they know what their purpose is, they just know how to get there, or they still feel lost, but they know the general direction. And the other side is, I don't even know what my passion is, I don't even know what my dreams are. And I lived on both terms, you know? Like I said at the beginning of the video, I have felt lost, and I have felt like I didn't know what I wanted to do in my life. And now I'm at a point where I have a general direction, but sometimes I feel lost, you know? Sometimes you get lost. Even when you know the way, which way to go, you'll get lost sometimes. That's the natural ebbs and flows of life. But you'll realize, once you figure out what your dream is in your life, in this world we call your own, life is interesting. You know, you'll go through many things in your life where, especially if you're chasing your dream, you're gonna have heartbreaks, you're gonna have devastation, you're gonna have so many negative things in your life, but also you're gonna have love, you're gonna have beauty, you're gonna have all these other positive things in life. And you won't know the ebbs and flows of that if you're not going out and doing what you love and trying to figure out what that dream is and just experimenting on different things. And you'll realize from this book and from your life that life gets very interesting when you're going after your dream and doing what you love. Now, the biggest takeaway that you're gonna get away from this book, that I took away from this book, that most people take away from this book is, follow your heart and the world will be on your side. Wherever your heart is, there you will find the treasure. Now, the whole general philosophy of this book is young man Santiago following his personal legend, following signs from the universe, following signs from himself that, you know what? You need to do what you love. You need to do what you're passionate about. You might hear from your parents, you might hear from society that this isn't the route for you. But at the end of the day, look, it's your life. You, your mind, your soul knows what you need to be in this world and know what you want to do in this world. And what I took away from that is, I was living by other people's rules. I was living by other people's means of what success really meant. And once I broke that and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna do what I love. I'm gonna do what my heart tells me, and I'm gonna do what I'm passionate about, my life changed forever. And a quote I wanna read you from the book is this, and when you want something, all of the universe conspires in your favor. Look guys, the world, the universe, your heart, it's on your side. I know you're feeling lost right now, and I know you feel like you can't get unstuck, but I promise you, as soon as you start following your heart, as soon as you start following your own will, your own soul, and you start to forget what everyone else says and you block them out, your life is gonna change dramatically. Follow your personal legend. Follow your personal heart. That's the biggest takeaway you're gonna get from this book. Again, guys, The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho changed my life forever. And I promise you, if you read this book, it will change your life forever. Description below, I'm gonna put an Amazon link of how to get it. I don't get paid off of it. I just really want you to read this book. Go to your local library, go on Amazon, whatever you need to do, download this book, buy this book, because I promise you, if you're at a point in your life where you don't know what to do, this is gonna help you no matter what. And that wraps up this book review from your boy Esai, aka The Alchemist. I wanna thank you for watching, thank you for listening, if you're on the podcast. If you're watching this on YouTube, definitely like the video, share it with a friend that needs this, share it with anyone that needs this, and subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate it. If you're listening on the podcast, definitely download the podcast, rate it 5 stars. I would love and appreciate you guys so much. Other than that, peace, love, and namaste, guys. Like always and every day, I want to wish you guys a blessed, positive, and happy day. And I love you guys. Peace.